Good Lord, didn't anybody here subscribe? Thank you.
Captain's log, stardate 45349.1. The Enterprise is on its way to Penthara 4, where a Type C asteroid has struck an unpopulated continent. The resulting dust cloud could very well create a phenomenon not unlike the nuclear winters of 21st century Earth. Commander LaForge has begun work on a plan that would counteract the devastation.
I'm afraid the numbers coming in are already indicating climactic changes, Commander.
What kind of drop can we expect?
If the Pentharan spheral forecasts are correct, 10 to 12 degrees Celsius within the first 10 days.
If it continues like that, their entire ecosystem will be shot to hell.
And I doubt if they're prepared to cope with the kind of cold that's coming.
Commander Riker?
Yes, sir.
Could you join me on the bridge, please?
Right away, sir.
You said, Mr. Worf?
There was a space-time distortion, sir, and there is something back there. We passed within 300 kilometers of it.
It's too close to be a coincidence. Miss LaForge?
Yes, Captain?
Would a delay of 1 hour affect your plans?
Not unless another asteroid decides to play a call on Pentara, sir.
The odds of that occurring, Captain, are extremely unlikely given the time frame.
Thank you, Mr. Data. Ensign, bring the ship about. Let's take a look at Mr. Worf's distortion.
Aye, sir.
Mr. Worf's what?
The Lieutenant's sensors have detected a temporal distortion almost in our current course. There's a small object back there that wasn't there a few moments ago.
The object is 50 kilometers ahead, sir.
Full stop, Ensign.
Aye, sir.
On screen.
Dimensions, Worf?
Approximately 5 meters in length, sir.
Life signs?
No signs of any kind. Our sensors do not penetrate the hull.
Try hailing it.
Well, that's odd.
What's odd?
We've received a response, but...
Yes, Mr. Worf.
They want you to move over, sir.
Reply that the Enterprise isn't going anywhere, Lieutenant.
Not the Enterprise, Captain. You.
What are you trying to tell me, Mr. Worf?
Whoops. Excuse me, Captain, but you were standing right where I needed to be.
Who are you?
Rasmussen's the name, sir. Professor Berlinghoff Rasmussen.
Oh, this is wonderful.
Actually, quite a bit larger than I thought.
Really?
Where I come from, every historian knows the bridge of old 1701D.
Where exactly do you come from?
My birth. The late 26th century Earth, to be exact. I've traveled back nearly 300 years just to find you.
Exactly what kind of historian are you?
My focus is on the 22nd through the 24th centuries, early interstellar history. You know, it was always believed this was on your desk, not here. Fascinating. Don't you move it on my account.
You can't expect me to believe that the layout of my ready room can possibly be of interest to future historians.
Oh, no less so than your legendary modesty, Captain. I can describe to you what a thrill it is to be here. This is the original.
You flatter me, Professor, but I can't help but wonder what could possibly have caused you to select me as a subject for your study. Even in this decade, there are far wiser and more experienced humans in and out of Starfleet.
Well, I'd love to tell you, Picard, I really would, but... Try and imagine what a young Caesar might have done differently had someone given him a hint of what lay ahead, or if Lincoln had been coerced into changing his theater plans. I truly wish I could be more specific on why you were selected, but I'm afraid the exchange of information will have to flow in one direction only. 5, 6, 7 meters.
Ha! I was right.
I love beans, diggity doo.